Hello there, in this episode we're gonna behold some brutal fighting scenes. Grab your snacks and drinks and let's go! And the first to start is a final fighting scene from the movie Goon. It's a brutal hockey beatdown.
The Thug Black is about to fucking drop the gloves and take on Ross, the boss, Ray. This has all the elements of a fucking sports masterpiece. Holy fuck, we got the worried lady friend.
Face frozen with concern. We got the gay brother.
Yep. And the lovable, wisecracking Mick best friend, Orangetown son, pussy crew, album drop. Oh, fuck, here we go. Here we go. Oh, my God.
You fucking dare.
Come on, Doug. He's okay, sis. He's always had bad fucking ankles.
You got him. Come on, Dougie. Come on, get up.
You're a fucking warrior, Doug!
Come on, Doug!
He's not done yet.
Second one, the art of self-defense. Also brutal karate training scene.
Our limbs get their strength from leverage points.
An elbow can only bend one way because if it could bend more than one way, it would be weaker. But this design is also inherently flawed. Henry, come on up to the front. I want you to help me demonstrate something. Watch closely. Leverage is a weapon. You can use it, or it can be used against you. You earned your blue belt. I know I could never take that from you. So I took your arm instead. Never come back here. Not even for the day class. Everyone, I'd like you to welcome Casey to the night class. He's a yellow belt.
All right,
let's begin.
You're done for the night.
So is he.
Can you drag him off the mat? Learn to love this feeling. You know, your bones aching, your chest screaming. This is karate. I have nothing else. Congratulations on a great class, everyone. Let's begin to cool down.
Third one is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood with friendly contest between Bruce and Brad.
Father, you're the one with the big mouth. And I would really enjoy closing it, especially in front of all my friends. But my hands are registered as lethal weapons. That means we get into a fight, I accidentally kill you, I go to jail.
Anybody accidentally kills anybody in a fight, they go to jail. It's called manslaughter. And I think all that lethal weapon horse shit is just an excuse so you dancers never have to get in a real fight.
Okay. How about a friendly contest? No punching in the face. 2 out of 3. Who puts who on the ground first? Nobody tries to hurt nobody. Just who ends up on their butt?
That's a great idea, Kato.
You know, Bruce, that guy's kind of famous.
That guy? For what?
He killed his wife and got away with it.
That guy?
That guy.
Bad, Kato. Try that again. You're right, Janet. I'm sorry about that.
Don't fucking Janet me, you prick!
Hey! What's up, babe?
What's up, Randy, is that your loser asshole wife-killing buddy boy here was beating the shit out of Bruce!
What?
Hey, Randy.
Cliff! What the fuck, man?
Let me just say, nobody beat the shit out of Bruce. It was a friendly contest. He barely touched me.
I think that dent in the car says something different.
What the fuck did you do to her car?
Well, I threw this little prick into it, but I did not know it was her car.
Get the wardrobe off! Get your shit! And get fucked!
Janet!
What?
I will handle this.
Then fucking handle it, Randy!
Cliff. Get the wardrobe off. Get your shit. And get off the lot.
Fourth on the list is Sherlock Holmes. Nice old school bare knuckle fighting.
That's it, big man. We're done. You won. Congratulations.
Oi, we ain't done yet.
This mustn't register on an emotional level. First, distract target. Then block his blind jab. Counter with cross to left cheek. Discombobulate. Dazed, he'll attempt wild haymaker. Employ elbow block and body shot. Block feral left. Weaken right jaw. Now fracture. Break cracked ribs. Traumatize solar plexus. Dislocate jaw entirely. Heel kick to diaphragm. In summary, ears ringing, jaw fractured, 3 ribs cracked, 4 broken, diaphragm hemorrhaging. Physical recovery, 6 weeks. Full psychological recovery, 6 months. Capacity to spit it back of head, neutralized.
Fifth one is a scene from Fight Club. This movie never gets old, and so does Jared Leto.
Every panda that wouldn't screw to save its species. I wanted to open the dump valves on oil tankers and smother all those French beaches I'd never see. I wanted to breathe smoke.
Where'd you go, psycho boy?
I felt like destroying something beautiful.
Get him to a fucking hospital.
Next one is a scene from Mission Impossible Fallout. Restroom wrecking experience with Tom Cruise.
Qu'est-ce qu'on peut joindre à vous? On va pas vous manger, les gars. On y va?
Avec quoi?
Ugh.
Can you still make a mask?
I need a face to make a mask.
Sorry. I was aiming for his chest.
What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too.
I'm sorry, I'm confused. You are...
an old friend.
Now, another rest from Pickle from Netflix series, The Punisher.
I think you guys have the wrong person here.
You wish we did.
Get back.
Ready?
All right, kid.
No shots.
Nobody mentioned the guy with her.
Dumbass. You're so far over your head, you can't even see the light.
Is that right?
I'm not your enemy.
Those photos, who paid for them? Who?
They would kill me if I told.
What the fuck am I gonna do?
Poloznev. Nikolai Poloznev.
What do I find?
Try the internet. Mudak.
Next one is French movie District 13, or Banlieue 13. I hope I pronounced that right.
709B13, I'll call you back if I'm still alive.
B13? Like Barrio 13?
Yeah.
Doesn't it seem strange that the bump's code is Barrio 13, 92, 93, the two zones we're in?
Just coincidence.
Damien, wait, hold on. If the bomb wasn't scheduled to come here, why the hell does it have the same number as this barrio?
Look, whatever it is, I've got to stop it, okay?
Damien, listen, what if it's the reverse?
The reverse of what?
You detonate the bomb with the code instead.
Why send me then if they wanted the fucking thing to explode in the first place? Explain that!
So it blows up right here where they want, the center barrier 13. Give me the exact spot. Wasn't that what your boss asked?
Yeah, but that's a security measure.
It's a trap, Damien, I'm sure.
Get off my back and let me work!
I've already saved your life once, so trust me!
I'm a soldier! I've got a mission to do! Later in 1 minute, we're all gonna
open your eyes, Damien. Nobody gives a shit about this barrio. 20 years and they can't solve the problem. They built a wall around this, now they're gonna clean it out for good. How come there are no civil servants here? No post office or schools, and just by chance, the police station was shut down.
But the bomb was stolen later, they didn't make that up.
Oh yeah, the van was attacked by some bad guys, right?
Yeah?
That's the story they told you, huh?
Yeah?
Then tell me why, just before we saw the van, it was intact. Where were the signs of an explosion, of a smashed-in door?
Maybe it was a different one.
It was the same, and you know damn well. And once they were sure the bomb was on the inside of Barrier 13 and that it wasn't gone anywhere, they got their best pit bull to set it in motion. And you really accomplished that mission. You stopped Tara from dumping it, so it's all for us.
You don't kill 2 million people because you can't solve their problem.
No, they murdered 6 million because none of them were blonde with blue eyes.
Sorry, Leto.
I prefer dying for my brother's dumb ideas than for yours.
Ninth place is a scrap scene between Tom Hardy's twins from the movie Legend.
Ron, shut up. I want you to apologize to Francis right now.
Right. Right. All right. Francis.
I'm sorry, right? Yes. I'm truly very sorry. The club is very, very empty. Bit like you, really. There's fuck all in it, apart from my brother's cock.
You, right? I'm a fucking disgrace, mate.
You hit me.
Yeah.
No! No! No!
No! Run!
Sweetheart, please leave.
Scene for today's episode is from the movie The Red Redemption. This movie is loaded with tons of great fights. If you're into that kind of stuff, definitely check it out. Well, that's it for today's episode. Hope you liked it. See you in the next one. Subscribe, like, comment. Bye-bye.